Hi, I'm Jay from Real Street Performance. Today we're going to talk about rod bolt torque and stretch. This is an ARP bolt stretch gauge. We sell it here at Real Street, so you can call one of your sales guys and put an order in if you want to add this to your arsenal of tools. And it helps remove any inaccuracy that your torque wrench may have, because you're basically giving yourself a way to double check your math. You're going to want to check the bolt length at a relaxed state. So the bolt has a little divot in the end and also a radiused recessed area in the head that, when you put these two together, kind of snaps into place and it'll kind of hang out there. And you can then zero out the gauge. Once you've got the gauge zeroed out and the bolt is not torqued, you can kind of run it up and then check stretch. While you're torquing the bolt, it's important that you have a known good torque wrench and that you are strong enough to torque the fastener up in an even pull. You do not want to be bouncing on this wrench to tighten it up. So I'll just kind of nose it up to get the bolt tight in the rod and then just run it to its stretch. And then, obviously in the engine it's a little bit different dynamic, but we're just doing this on the bench. Then you can plop the torque stretch gauge back on and check and see where you're at for a stretch. This is 6.3 to 6.7. We're like 6.2 there. So we're gonna call this particular bolt and this particular torque reading pretty accurate. Also, when you're identifying your fasteners, look at the end of the fastener. Typically, they're labeled in the length and the material. This is an ARP 2000. You may buy some 625 pluses, or you may get a base ARP fastener, which won't have this marking on it at all. All fasteners will carry their own specified torque and stretch. Hope you enjoy these little bits of information. If you'd like to subscribe, you can click the link below. We'll be doing more of these moving forward and some other stuff that we do here at Real Street.